Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. For those of you that thought the channel might be dead, it kind of was, but I've not given up completely. We're coming towards the end of 2023 and I wanted to just kind of give you guys a little, I don't know, feedback, update, see where we're going, where we've been, that kind of thing. So what have I been up to in the time since we last spoke? Well, the biggest thing, of course, was mixed with the Masters. So I went to the south of France in October to spend a week with none other than Chris Lord-Alge. Now, any of you that know me well enough will know that this guy has been my absolute idol since I was probably 15 years old. And so this opportunity to go and be with him was very, very exciting. And obviously I jumped at that chance. So how was it? Well, for want of a better word, life-changing. He's a really, really nice guy. He's got an open book kind of policy where he doesn't hold back any secrets. He is completely open. You ask him a question, he'll give you an answer. And I think, to me, this brought about a realisation that certainly during mixing, I was perhaps overcomplicating things a little. And I came back with my head buzzing with ideas. Now, for those of you that are fans of Rosellas, you'll know that they recently released a new single called The Same Curse. Now, what you don't know is that mix that is out is the complete rework of that song. It's the second mix. We originally had the three songs that are out signed off by the band. Everything was fine. I keep saying we. I mean I originally had them signed off. But coming home from spending time with Chris, I was so buzzing with ideas. I just figured that I might be able to make these tracks a lot better. So I contacted the band and I was like, hold up, wait a minute. Let me just hit them again and see if I can get them any better. And so I started the entire process from scratch. And I feel that the end result is a hell of a lot better than it was originally. I'm much happier with how they turned out. And that's only really the beginning. I've changed my entire workflow. I've changed many things about my process. And I'm going to do mixing overviews, tutorials, deep dives in the future. And I'll go into that in a little bit more depth and tell you all about the way things work now. In June, I had weight loss surgery because I was very fucking fat and I was tired of it. I'm not going to go into too much detail about that here because it's really not that important. But if I'm looking thinner, that will be why. I've currently lost 8 stone, which in kilos, 50 something, I think. So it's going pretty well. And there'll be more to come, I guess, in terms of weight loss over the next 18 months or so. So that's exciting. I have also purchased a bunch of new gear, sold a few bits, got a few bits. I got rid of the Presonus Vader port that I was using for mixing because two reasons. One, well, all right, let me backtrack. The main thing is I've gone back to Pro Tools. I've been in Logic for quite a while, but ultimately the call of the tools was strong and I miss it. And so I've gone back to it. That has an inherent problem. And that problem is that Pro Tools, to get into a little bit of geekery here, but Pro Tools has something in it called Huey, which is a protocol in which it talks to external hardware, such as control surfaces and things like that. The problem with Huey is it's archaic and shit, and so things like fader resolution is not good. It's very, very agricultural, and making fine fader moves for automation is basically not possible. And So I found that I'd gone back to using a mouse and just didn't really touch the fader port. Now in Logic this is different, that uses a protocol called MCU, which is a lot more fine. So I took it upon myself to sell the fader port and instead go big, and I've bought an Avid S3, which I'll do a little review on at some point. I mean, I know it's a few years old now, but I'll give you my thoughts on the S3 and why I ultimately chose to go for that over something like the S1 or a smaller unit. Other than that, I've gone to mixing with a summing mixer now, summing box. So I've got a Dangerous Music 2 Bus LT. I've picked up a DBX 160, a Line 6 Echo Pro, a couple of LA3As. There's been some purchasing. All for the greater good though, which I'm hoping will come across in videos, and you will see that it is for a reason and it has a benefit. I've got plenty of projects booked in next year, and I'm also coming to you from a new camera. So my partner Maggie is a photographer, and she was on a Canon 5D Mark IV, which is what I've been using for basically most of the entirety of this channel, but she's recently switched to the Sony A7 IV. Which made me very, very excited, because I've seen a lot of other channels and YouTubers using these Sony cameras, and I've always been besotted with how cinematic they look. So hopefully this video doesn't look like shit and I've done a good job of colour grading. But you can't be a master of everything. I'll do my best. But I'm excited about using this camera, and that's kind of what prompted me to make another video, because obviously Christmas came, she got the camera, she started taking some pictures, and I kind of had a little play around with it, and I was like, oh shit, this looks good. This looks really good. And then I thought, I should probably make another video, really, and give it a run out. So this will be my first video on the A7 IV. I am not a videography channel. I'm not doing any tutorials on colour grading or any of that kind of thing. But for those of you that are interested, that's what I'm currently shooting on, and we are at 35mm, currently 35mm lens at f1.8, should you really wish to know. Other than that, I'm going to start doing a lot more in-studio content. I've got some plans for 2024, but the biggest thing about 2024 is I am going to LA to meet with Chris Lord-Alge again. So me and him got on really well. We've kept in touch after the masterclass, and he has gracefully invited me out. He has invited me out to visit Mix LA in Tarzana, California. Any of you that are fans of CLA will know about Mix LA. It's god tier level in terms of outboard gear and an SSL and all that gear. And I've really wanted to see this place since I was a kid. I've idolised it. And I told him this. We had a little one-to-one. All of the students that went to Mix with the Masters got a one-to-one with Chris. And in mine, I said to him, you know, kids growing up have pictures of football stars or Spider-Man on the bedroom wall. I had pictures of Mix LA on my wall. And he was like, dude, he was like, come and visit, man, anytime. And at first I thought, he's probably just saying that, you know, he knows a lot of people. He probably gets a lot of requests for this kind of thing. But anyway, after the seminar, I did send him a couple of emails. We exchanged a few emails, and I said to him, listen, you know, if that offer is legit, I would love to come. And he was like, dude, I meant it. Come down, you know, scheduling allowing, of course. You know, let's talk and we'll figure it out. And I thought, So, to LA I go. I'm going to arrange this with Chris in the new year to make sure he's there. And, you know, flights from the UK to LA are not cheap, so I can't afford for him not to be there, obviously. So, I'll do some filming in LA as well. It'll be my first time there. I'm really looking forward to it. And I should be, hopefully, attending a Mixers event, which more details to be shared on that at a later date. But anyway, that's all from me. There is more to come. I've got some bits of tutorials, I've got some, you know, bits of stuff that I'm planning, which I'm going to start trying to pump out a little bit more content again and revive the channel, as it were. So thanks for sticking with the channel, all of you that have subscribed recently. Thank you for continuing to like and comment on the videos. I appreciate it. and just know that I am here. I'm just a busy Gary, and I will put some content up as soon as I can. Other than that, I hope everybody has had a great 2023. Enjoy the new year. Don't get too drunk. I'll see you in 2024. Peace.